Turnout here tonight. We're so thankful. Appreciate everybody that came out tonight to the Rivertown Bluegrass Society. We don't usually have this good a turnout, but we appreciate that very, very much. Are you enjoying yourself? Good, good. So glad you are. So glad you are. Roger sent me a message by Miss Bonnie. I just want to share. I know I told you earlier that Mr. Haywood did pass away. Some of you know him. And the funeral will be 3 o'clock tomorrow at Mount Tabor Baptist Church in Georgetown, South Carolina. 3 o'clock at Mount Tabor. Okay, and I hadn't heard anything from Brooke, so I don't think the baby's made it here yet, so we still waiting on that. But you guys want to come on around? We'll get started here. And get back on track. You gonna need to do a soundtrack or anything? Okay. Oh, I'm not sure. What time we getting ready to do a soundtrack? I want to tell you about our sister association, Southeastern Bluegrass Association, over on Highway 52 between Darlington and Hartsville. They hold their concert on the first Saturday night of the month. If you get an opportunity to go by and see them, they have a concert such as this there. They got a fine facility there on Highway 52 between Darlington and Hartsville. They're Southeastern Bluegrass Association, and you can find them as well on the web, southeasternbluegrassassociation.org.
Check, 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 check. Check, check, check. Test, test, test.
So where do you want me? Here, is here good still?
That's where we were at before, and she was in.
Right. I need to slide this.
There you go.
Check, check.
We still have one more in there, but that's all right. Yeah.
That's where you're ready.
Hey, Tom.
The banjo band
was so they want Tom to go down and let me go down.
There you go.
Oh, okay. Bless your heart and all your vital organs.
I've heard that quote before.
Don't break up the family now. Let's all
right, here
keep
we go.
Close together.
Don't break up me.
one more time. Davis and Bradley Band.
Just another lonesome day, and I know you want me far away. Hey, you don't love me anymore, my darling. I'm just used to be. That I could melt your heart of stone. And you don't miss me anymore, my darling, 'cause I'll have to live my life alone. Now hope that tomorrow you will say that you're gonna come back home to stay. Hey, you don't love me anymore, my darling, I'm just used to be.
Okay, well, while they're back there playing around, hope y'all had a good break. We had a nice time visiting with some folks. We appreciate you coming by and talking to us. We're going to do an instrumental for you now. We recorded this on our last Bluegrass CD. What better instrumental to do, but one that was written by the father of bluegrass music, Mr. Bill Monroe. This is a great song. He actually won a Grammy for this, so... This goes to show the amazing talent that he had in songwriting and the innovator that he was in this great music.
Bill Monroe didn't believe in this wires and stuff.
Well, we won't tell him.
He'd be half through the song by now.
A little bit of southern flavor. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you. We're gonna try to play more talk less this set and get through some of our favorite songs here for you. This being our last set and everything. But we spent some time doing some introductions during our first show, and we talked about what everybody does, and we talked about Tom being such a wonderful bass player, but he's also such a wonderful singer and been part of some real historic singing records along the way. And we're gonna turn him loose and let him sing one. This is.
Okay.
This has become one of our favorites here.
Our favorite, we worked it up this afternoon. Or was it still morning?
Snowing mantle cold and clean, the unborn grass I'm waiting for its coat to turn to green. The snowbird sings a song he always sings that speaks to me of flowers that will bloom again in spring. When I was young, my heart was young then too. Anything that it would tell me, that's the thing that I would do. Such emptiness within me, for the thing that I want most in life, the thing that I can't win.
Spread your tiny wings and fly away,
and take the snow back with you where it came from on that day.
The one I love forever is untrue,
and if I could,
you know that I would fly away with you.
seems to say she'd only break my heart again should I decide to stay. So little Slover, take me with you when you go to that land of gentle breezes where the peaceful waters flow.
Spread your tiny wings and fly away,
and take the snow back with you where it came from on that day.
The one I love forever is untrue, and if I could, you know that I would fly away with you.
Yeah, if I could, you know that I would fly.
All right, Tom Gray. Thank you, Tom. Now, I know when I was a kid, my dad sang, and he was a country music singer, and we used to play a lot of music at our house. And if you have children, you know that sometimes it's hard to find common ground with your children musically. And I guess for me, I was very lucky, and I would find common ground with my dad on a lot of music. But one thing we used to like to do, actually the whole family would do it, as we watched the Glenn Campbell Good Time Hour. Remember that show? So we'd all kind of get together and watch that. And Glenn Campbell was one of those first guys to play one of those round back guitars. If you're a guitar picker, you know exactly what I mean. It was made by the company called Ovation.
And you said they make helicopters?
Yeah, it seemed like a natural transition.
It was a bad idea.
Maybe the guitar will float or fly or something. I don't know. But they're great sounding guitars. And he used to watch that show, and every week he'd go, oh, I got to get me one of them guitars, you know. And it's like, every week, I got to get me one of them guitars. He finally breaks down and gets one of the guitars like Glenn Campbell, and was never really happy with the guitar. And in his own words, not my words, he says, I never accounted for how challenging it would be to balance that round back guitar against my round front body. And he's kind of doing one of these all the time, and finally broke down and got a more conventional guitar, which gave me a little more time to learn this song that we used to play together back in those days. Gentle on My Mind. Snowing at your door, but it's always open and your path is free to walk. Makes me tend to leave my sleeping bag rolled up in the stash behind the couch. It's snowing out my jacket, my forgotten words or bombs, or the ink stains that have dried upon some lines. And keeps you in the back roads by the rivers of my memory, ever smiling, ever gentle on my mind. It's not clinging to the rocks and ivy planted on their columns now that binds me, or something that somebody said cause they thought we'd fit together walking. It's just hoping that the world will not be cursing or forgiving as I walk along some railroad track and find, moving on the back roads by the rivers of my memory, smiling at your channel on my mind. Highways come between us. Some other woman's crying to her mother cause she turned and I was gone. I still might run in silence, tears of joy might stain my face, the summer sun might burn me till I'm blind, but not to where I cannot see you moving on the back roads, like the rivers flowing gentle on my mind. the suit back, and gurgling, crackling, cauldron in some tray yard. My boots are rougher than coal pile, dirty hat will blow across my face. Two cupped hands round a tin can, I pretend to hold you to my breast and fire. You're moving on the back roads by the rivers of my memory, ever smiling, ever gentle on my mind. You're moving on the back roads by the rivers of my memory, ever smiling, ever gentle on my mind. One of our favorite old Buck Owens songs for you, and we play this one at weddings sometimes. It's kind of a love song but a foot tapper at the same time. We'll let Richie get caught up on his tune in here as he kicks it off. So
I heard take your time, Richie.
We played this for a wedding last year. It was a lot of fun. We had put together a few songs of a country theme, including the one that we played earlier, Walk Through This World With Me. And then we had this Buck Owens song in our back pocket. Oh, my heart skips a beat. Take the day I met you. My heart turned to flip when I stood next to you.
And I knew right then I never could forget you. For you are my every dream come true. And my heart skips a beat. We walk down the street. I feel a trembling in my knees. And just to know you're mine to the end of time makes my heart skip a beat.
To my life without a warning, turn my cloudy skies from gray to blue.
You're my sunshine that comes up every morning. Yes, you are my every dream come true. And my heart skips a beat. We walk down the street. I feel trembling in my knees. And just to know you're mine till the end of time makes my heart skip a beat.
Another song from our Into the Blues CD that we made last year. Now this year we put out, and we weren't pitching it so much because it's a little bit out of season now, but we put out a Christmas DVD. It was a little bit of a different project for us. We take the contributions of folks who come to see us play and from our CD purchases, and we roll it all over into new projects. This year we have a couple of ideas for new projects, a little bit undecided yet, but we're talking about a few things. But we made a Christmas DVD this last year. If you got by our record table, you probably saw that. And that was a lot of fun to make. And Kathy, your mom said I had a face made for radio. Was that a compliment from her?
I think so. She meant it, too. Yeah, she was fine.
prior to that, we the year before, we made this DVD, and we got a really nice couple of reviews on it in some of the bluegrass magazines. Bluegrass Today had given us some favorable reviews, and the fellow who reviewed it commented that he thought this was his favorite song on the CD. And we'll play it for you. It's a beautiful song. It is written by Toby Keith and Chris Ledoux. It's called Under the Rodeo Moon. We took her daddy's old two-horse trailer, patched a place in the floor that was bad. I loaded up her barrel pony and her rigging bags, all that I had. We left with our suitcases filled with desire, $400 and two good spare tires. Now our windshield's a painting that hangs in our room. It changes with each mile like a radio tune. Caught up above, we'll make it home. Now sometimes we'd sleep in a hotel when we're riding that hot hand of luck. Sometimes we'd sleep at a friend's house. Sometimes we just sleep in the truck. Nighttimes you'll find us out in the fast lane, staying one step ahead of the snow and the rain. Now our windshield's a painting hangs in on. It changes with each mile like a radio tune. Caught up above, we'll make it home, love, under the rodeo. $400 and two good spare tires. Now our windshield's a painting that hangs in our room. It changes with each mile like a radio tune. God help above, we'll make it on.
Thank you so much. Appreciate that. did a good one. Good job.
When we were working on our record, my mom, who's 85 years old, God bless her, she does her best to keep up with everything that we're working on and where we're playing and what we're doing, and she doesn't get out to see us as much as I would like, but she's always asking me, oh, what are you working on? What are you doing? And she was asking me about our new CD, when it was new and we were working on it. I mentioned to her that we were writing some songs, and she wanted to know more, and I said, Mom, I think you'll like it. I said, we're writing a really nice gospel song to kick off the CD. And I said, it's right out of the book of Luke about come unto him as children, humble yourself before the Lord. She said, sounds beautiful. What do you call it? I said, we call it get off your high horse and get down on your knees.
She said, I told you that a few times, right?
Very many times. But we'll play it for you. We hope you like it. Get off your high horse and get down on your knees.
Trust in your Savior, your hopes in times of need. Don't put pride in your own power, and you must believe. You must take Jesus, and from your burdens you'll be free. So get off of your high horse, get down on your knees. Trust in the Savior, only in the Savior. He hears our prayers and pleas.
He is our salvation.
We come to Him as children. We must get down off our high horse, get down on our knees. The Lord a life of sin he led. He did not stand for Jesus when he washed his hands instead. He should have bowed before and pled the Spirit to be freed. Should have got down off his high horse, got down on his knees. Trust in the Savior, only in the Savior. He hears our prayers and pleas.
He is our salvation.
We come to him as children. We must get down off our high horse, get down on our knees. Sin, he was too proud to believe. His heart was bound in hate, could never be set free. Then the Savior came and forgave his evil deeds. When he got down off his high horse, got down on his knees. Trust in the Savior, only in the Savior. He hears our prayers and pleas.
He is our salvation.
We come to him as children. We must get down off our high horse, get down on our knees. Savior, only in the Savior, He hears our prayers and pleas.
He is our salvation.
We come to Him as children. We must get down off our high horse, get down on our knees. We must get down off our high horse, get down on our knees.
Thank you. Now, we had sold a couple of CDs. We were playing up in the Winchester, Virginia area, and about 3 weeks later, we got a text message from a feller, and he goes, really like your new CD. He says, our church loves that song, and we play it on the speakers every Sunday while people are coming in to sit down. And I thought, isn't that so nice that they don't tickle around the message there? They just put it right out there. Get off your high horse. Get in your seat, please. We're ready to begin. So hats off to them. But, folks, we get time for a couple more, and on this one we've been having a whole lot of fun with. And we'll call on Richie Dotson to kick it off on the banjo for you again. One's called the Deep Elm Blues.
When you go to bellin' when I'm getting deep bellin' blues. Oh, sweet mama, daddy's got the deep bellin' blues. Oh, sweet mama, daddy's got the deep bellin' blues. Now it's I knew a preacher preached the Bible through and through, and he went down to deep bellin' now his preaching is true. Oh, sweet mama, daddy's got the deep bellin' blues.
Got time for one more, and we're going to say thank you so much. Thanks to the folks here at the Rivertown Bluegrass Association for having us back here. This is our second visit here. We're having a wonderful time. We've been all over the Carolinas this week and started out the Music Hall in Darlington. They do a wonderful bluegrass show out there. If you guys have not gone to that, it's certainly worth the trip. And they have a wonderful facility and great music there and just great folks. And thanks to everybody who's been so welcoming to us and all of you. And I always say this, and sometimes it sounds kind of corny to say, but you know, it's important to get out and support live music. And you folks do that. A lot of people talk about it, but you don't always see their faces in the crowd. And you folks come out and you support your local bluegrass society and you support us and you make us want to do it again and again and again. So we think there's something very special about who you are, and you're welcome to give yourselves a big round of applause too. So
And thank you so much. Awesome sound back there.
The
you guys
sound
wouldn't
is wonderful.
Hear us if we didn't have them back there working hard. So.
And folks,
so
the
much.
Kevin Prater Band is going to come back, and they're going to hit it out of the park like they always do. We love those guys. We think they're the best of the best, and always look forward to sharing the stage with them. So we're going to leave you with this one. We put this on our last CD, and then not because we forgot we did it. We went ahead and put it on another CD too, because we're invited to be part of a compilation Southern Gospel CD, and we always like to close with a gospel song. We never want to forget who it is that that gives us the opportunity and the gifts to do what we do. So thank you very much, and God bless you from the Davis Bradley Band. Richie Dotson on the 5-string banjo. Mr. Tom Gray on the bass fiddle. Kathy Davis on the mandolin. My name's Bradley Bishop. Thank you so much. We're going to leave you with this. Walking in Jerusalem, just like John. Oh, John, John, what did you say? Walking in Jerusalem, just like John. I'll be there on the judgment day. Walking in Jerusalem, just like John. I want to be ready. I want to be ready. Walking in Jerusalem just like John. Now some come walking and some come lame. Walking in Jerusalem just like John. Some come walking in Jesus' name. Walking in Jerusalem just like John. I want to be ready. I want to be ready. I want to be ready, Lord, to walk in Jerusalem just like John. Mighty fine man, walking in Jerusalem just like John. Knows his Bible like the back of his hand, walking in Jerusalem just like John. I want to be ready, I want to be ready, I want to be ready, Lord, to walk in Jerusalem just like John. Cross on his shoulder, walking in Jerusalem just like John. I'll meet you there at the first crossover, walking in Jerusalem just like John. I want to be ready, I want to be ready, I want to be ready, Lord, to walk in Jerusalem just like John. Walking in Jerusalem just like John. I want to be ready. I want to be ready. I want to be ready, Lord, to walk in Jerusalem just like John. I want to be ready. I want to be ready. I want to be ready, Lord.
1, 2, 3, 4,
walk in Jerusalem just like John. All right, thank you. Thank you, everybody. We're humbled by that. Thank you so much.
Richie, do you want to know where you are, Tom?
Oh, of course I do.
All right.
E. I can remember down there.
Thank you, folks. We appreciate that. Again, it's been so meaningful to us to be able to play for y'all, and we hope to come back sometime. And look for us. We play kind of, I guess, you know, pretty much East Coast and points west. February we're in Nashville. That's about as far west as we've been going so far. We've been managing to stay busy on the East Coast, but we do have a website that's lots of fun to look at. There's song clips and some videos there and different things and some information about our sponsors and people that work with us that help us do what we do. This is our fourth year as a full-time working bluegrass group, and we're loving every day of it. And if it wasn't for y'all, I don't think we'd be able to last too long doing it. So thank you so much for your support and all the support that you lend to the bands that come in here. Thank you. We'll leave you with a good old bluegrass number. I wonder where you are tonight. Wondering if I'm alright to dream about you though you left me. I wonder where you are tonight. That old rain is cold and slowly falling upon my window.
night. And though your love is cold as even the first snow of the winter, I wonder where you are tonight.
Cold, you never loved me, although you often seem to care. And have you gone and found another, someone who knows the love I share?
That old rain is slowly falling, as a tear falls upon my window pane tonight. And though your love is cold as in the first snow of the winter, I wonder where you are tonight.
In my heart tonight.
That old rainy sun is cold and sad as a teardrop falling upon my window pane tonight. And though your love is cold as in the first snow of the winter, I wonder where you are tonight. Yes, I wonder where you are tonight.
Yeah. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. God bless you.
Davis and Bradley Band. Yay. Wow. Good job, it is. Good job. Appreciate that so very much. You think we need to get them back?
Yeah.
You think? Need to book them again?
Yeah.
All right. All right, Mickey, you heard that. Book them again, brother. If they'll be so glad to come play for us, we hope so anyway. All righty then. Something I had on my mind I want to tell you. I done crossed 50. I think, I could be sitting right here and all of a sudden, whoop, fly right straight through. Get lost as a bat. Just like that. But anyway. Are you enjoying yourself tonight? Good, good, good. I tell you, I'd be glad if Roger come back and help me out. Seems like he didn't get as confused as I do, but anyway.
Next thing, your hair turns gray. Hair turns gray next.
Yeah. Mine might turn loose before it turns gray, I don't know, but that'd be all good. I'm just blessed to be here. Amongst you fine people. That's good right there. All righty then. Maybe to come to me in a second. Yeah, that's right.
We got it.
That's right.
Thursday night.
Yeah, that's what it was. Thank you. Yeah, Miss Donna was over just a while ago, and she told me, that's Donna and Friends, I call it, night in the Cono Lodge there in Conway, Cono Lodge, every Thursday night from 6 to 8. They have bluegrass music there, over there, and they have good food and good fellowship. And she said, remind everybody the Marsh Brothers will be with them Thursday night. Thank you, Miss Bonnie. Well, I appreciate that. But I was really feeling bad for myself. Like, where did it get to? All right. I do want to thank Jared on the sound. He's doing a fine job tonight.
Yeah.
Job on the sound tonight, Jared. And,
check.
One, two, oh, there it is. One, two, oh, yeah, turn.
Yes, that's right.
Thank you. I like a good scrape boy.
Yeah.
two, one, two. That works.
Check, one, two. Give me just a little bit of this guitar in the monitor, Jared, if you could. Yep.
Check. Check, one, two. Yep. Sounds good to me. It's bass.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, the Kevin Prater Band.
Just before the children came,
through the long eternity. In the southern midnight, and the sun is calling me. Line up, my little brother, little Bessie Felsen.
be all right tomorrow. When be all right tomorrow, I'll be all right tomorrow. I'll be a little bit tired, be all right tomorrow. Oh, my baby's gone. I got a letter yesterday, said she'd come back to stay. Said she never leave my arms again.
Tight tonight. Share a new song with you right now. We actually, me and Tom was co-writers on this song with one of our departed friends, and his name was Jerry Williamson, and we put this song together back in the end of 1995, actually, and turned out to be a pretty good song for us at that time. We had done it at some of the festivals out in the Midwest, and we got a lot of really nice comments on this song, and I don't know why, it seemed like it kind of slipped by the wayside through the years. We'd done it for a while, and of course when we both left the band Red Wing, kind of got tossed away, and I don't understand it. We should have kept doing this song for a long time. But I love the words in this. It's very simple, and it explains love, I guess, the way it needs to be, like that. So, that's right. That's going to be on our new album. It's kind of short and sweet message, and it's entitled All I Ever Wanted. Appreciate that. I want to take just a quick moment to thank a very special gentleman that just come down here, walked down the audience, has made me a very happy man today. And gentleman you've seen up here playing banjo with Bradley Davis, and I can't say enough about Richie right now. This has been my old war horse pretty much since my mandolin career pretty much started. I got this mandolin as an endorsement in 1998 when I was with the James King Band, and it's been my old dreamboat, as I say. I get to play, and he kind of got under the weather on me back in the spring, and Richie came over. Richie's from my part of the country, actually. He was raised over in Phelps, Kentucky, and he's one of the greatest luthiers ever, and we can't say enough how much we appreciate him and his business, Acoustic Box. So if you're needing work done to any instrument, I highly recommend this gentleman and appreciate him so much for everything he's done for me. He's got my mandolin back in wonderful shape, and I'm proud to be an endorser for Ron Cole and the Cole Mandolins. I've had this mandolin since 98, as I said, so thank you, Richie. You meant the world to me, and I appreciate that very much. Richie Dotson right here, folks. I wished he'd put some of the right notes back on it for me, because I can't hear.
Yeah.
We got a special guest here, and we're going to let him come out and sing you a Jimmy Martian tune. Would you all say hello to my good friend Mickey Sellers right here? Just right quickly, I want to say this gentleman.
I'm fixing to destroy this show right here.
This gentleman right here brought our band down here the very first time 3 years ago, and to a great crowd of folks that night, and it was on a real short notice. And Mickey put a lot of belief in me and our band and the things that we do, and I can't say enough for this gentleman being so good to me, but most importantly, I can't say enough for the Rivertown Bluegrass Society, what they've been to the Kevin Prater Band and all the bands that get to come in here. This is one of the greatest venues that we ever get to play, and that's because of you folks sitting right there and because of these people working as hard as they do to promote bluegrass music in this area. So hats off to all you folks.
We got a really good crowd here tonight, Kevin, didn't you? I'm going to run every one of them off right here.
You didn't come dressed right to be Jimmy Martin, I can tell you that right now.
You don't think?
No. You ain't got nowhere near enough clothes on or nothing.
I ain't drunk enough either.
What you say? I wasn't going to go that far.
It's a beautiful gospel song. If y'all turn to page 129, sing with us. One entitled "When My Savior Reached Down for Me."
Once my soul was astray from the heavenly way, I was rigid and blind as could be. But my Savior in love gave me peace from above when he reached down his hand for me. When my Savior reached down for me, when he reached way down for me, I was lost and undone without God or Son. When he reached down his head for me, now my heart does rejoice when I hear his sweet voice, and the tempest to him I now cling. There to on his arms, safe, secure from all harm, when he reached down his hand for me. When my Savior reached down for me, when he reached way down for me, I was lost and undone without God or Son. When he reached down his
was lost and undone without God or son. When he reached down his hand for me.
Mickey Sellers right there, folks.
I've known Kevin here for a lot of years, and I've done sound for him a lot, even way back whenever he was with James King. And I had never played any music with Kevin before until just across the hall a little bit ago, and that's the first time on stage. And I really appreciate that, Kevin.
One of my greatest friends for almost 20 years, Mickey Sellers, right there. All right, now, we appreciate that. Oh, tune there, Shiny.
I appreciate it.
We got another very dear guest in the audience tonight. Somebody become very special to us down here. And going to sing her song right now. On our last project, we recorded a song written by one of my dear friends from back home, and the young man that Danny over here actually watched grow up as a kid. And Danny played a lot of music with his dad, and I'd say Richie probably remembers Keith's dad, Randall Hatfield. I know you remember Randall very well. You had to play around that area over there. But Keith wrote a lot of great songs. We included this song on our latest project, and actually got another one of his that who knows, we may get to it for the evening's out. But we got a dear friend that's in the audience, and this song is titled after her. Johnny Edward, that's right. But Keith wrote this song about his sweetheart, and she kind of took to this, and it put a smile on her face, so I'm going to do it especially for her. And the song is simply entitled Johnny. Johnny. the head of the hobby where the trees bend and sway. It's there that I go just to get away. I lay on my back and I stare at the sky, for my Tony's gone and I wonder why. I stare at the tree where we caught in her name. Then I close my eyes, things feel the same. I miss you so much, but there's nothing I can do. So I lay in this spot that I won't share with you. When I was a kid, for in this very place me and Johnny hid. Johnny was the only one that ever came here with me. Now she's passed on, I come here to grieve. I stand at the tree where we carved in her name. Then I close my eyes, things feel the same. I miss you so much, but there's nothing I can do. So I lay in this spot that I will share with you. Dressed in red, next come down in green, the next come down Lord Daniel's wife, fair as any queen. At the fifth of step, little Matthew Gross, can I go home with you tonight? I swear by the ring you wear on your finger, you're Lord Daniel's wife. Well, it makes no difference whose wife I am to you or no other man. Lord Daniel's not at home tonight, he's in a distant land. Young Matthew Gross was standing by, heard these words and said, if I don't die before daylight, Lord Daniel's will know then. He had 15 miles to go to Emma Demi Rock. He ran the cape to the broken down bridge, he'd give his breath and swan. Oh,
up about 12 men, got him by the free good will. He run me, came to the top of the hill, he give his bugle a drill. Seeing what is the matter, my fair young lad, what is the matter now? A man's in the bed with your own true love, and both their hearts are one. You killed little Matthew Grove, you killed him in his sin. I wouldn't have given this little finger for you and all your sin. Come here, my wife, to me, trotted her on his knee. Which one of these men do you like best, little Matthew Grove or me? He took her by her lily white hand, led her through the hall, took out his sword, cut off her head, hit it against the wall. Lord, mother dear, go dig my grave, dig it long and deep. Put Matthew Gross in my arms, Lord Daniels at my feet.
You know, last night we sung that murder song in an ice cream parlor. That ain't something you get to do very often. I love killing songs after two scoops of vanilla.
I like the vanilla before
and
after.
Jake said he likes the ice cream before and after. Didn't make no difference. He works up an appetite with him when he uses a sword. That song's written back in olden times, back when Tom was a kid. Yeah, Jake, Adam asked Tom last night, what did he do with his Pret Brontosaurus that he used to ride?
He grew up. Yeah. He's been running it down the road.
Okay. I wish he would.
Are you sure you're not a bottom? All right.
Well, let's see here.
Well, he wants to get that capo off.
Okay, I got to get Tom to sing a song. I'm trying to get him to sing his new song. I don't know what's wrong with him. Okay.
Well, I don't want to do the new one because I've rewritten it 16 times every time we've tried to play it. I don't know the words to it yet. I have to read them off a sheet, so I will pass on this one.
Richie Holmes, will you? Right.
Yeah.
You have to write limbs.
No, I want to do one instead. I'll get little brother here to help me.
I'll get him to do two songs here back to back. Then,
okay, there we go. Yeah, we'll do the Reno thing. Yeah, okay. An oldie but a goodie. I think you all remember. I think you sing right along with me. Me and the boys here. Jake, if you would. So I know you're married, but I love you still.
My heart spoke to me. It said to love you to eternity. Not knowing that you were another's bride, I love that always goes by your side. You know I love you and I always will. To belong to you again.
please me. I know you're married, but I love you still.
Here's Jake to do a little more Reno style picking for you. One entitled The Limehouse Blues. Slow things back down here and do you another love song here. How many married couples we got in the audience? Hands are kind of coming up real slow like that. How many of y'all happily married down here? How many out with the same one that you was the last trip you went out on? Oh, never mind. The reason why we usually say we play a lot of them places too, I guess. Kind of concern you when you see this, and you just get that significant one. She's like, she's sitting over, she's like, put your hand up. We're gonna do this for you happy couples, and for those of you that's really not sure what you are like that, we'll do it for you too. This song right here, when it's another Jerry Williamson song, actually. When Jerry introduced this song to me for the very first time, I went to work for Jerry actually as a banjo player, and then, of course, this one came along and took my job. I got fired and had to go back to the mainland. Things was going my way. Nevertheless, Jerry introduced this song to me, and it turned out to be one of my favorite songs that I've ever got to sing, and this is one of my mama's favorite tunes ever. I always think about her. I love the words of this song. I hope all you ladies and gentlemen out there love this song. It's got a beautiful message in it to it. For all you lovebirds, it's entitled Where There's a Will, There's a Way.
I thought of you again. this evening. It's the time that you like best, when the sun is slowly sinking across the mountains to the west. Do you remember our promise? Pledge of love we made that day. We said that love would last forever. Where there's a will, there's a way. Where there's a will, there's a way. Bring you safely to me. And today might be the day we live again our memory. There's a path leading home to my loving arms to stay. Promise me that you remember, where there's a will, there's a way.
That's a beautiful song. That's going to be coming out about mid-spring for us, good Lord willing, and everything. And we're so looking forward to that. And we've
let's see here.
I guess it's about time to
two more. Well, we better turn the fiddle player loose one more time, boys.
Yeah, look out.
Yeah. I told you that he might break dance on this show.
Okay. Breaking a little bit there last time.
Y'all enjoy this young man's fiddle playing, don't you? We're very proud of him. I'll tell you a quick story on him. We found this gentleman. We found him last year back in the spring. He was riding a bicycle and had a flat on it. We pulled over and he said, I've got a problem. He said, I'm not carrying a spare. And he said, can you help me out? Little did we know that he played the fiddle, but little did we find out that he danced on stage too. He brings so much joy to us up here on this stage, and we have so much fun with him. He's a big cuddly bear like that, so all you women, you got to kind of watch him like that. He gets around pretty women and starts feeling Baptist, and he feels like he just needs a hug and all that. The problem of it is he don't like to let go. That's the Pentecostal side of him when he don't let go. Watch it, Richie.
Oh, my goodness.
Do it to it, son. This is all you.
Thank you.
Nashville. Thanks for being having fun with the Kevin Prater Band tonight. Oh, we've had so much fun with you all. Would you like to see us come back and do this again sometime? Well, we sure hope so. We got time to do you one more number. Thank you so much to the Rivertown Bluegrass Society for letting us be a part of this for the last 3 years. It's been wonderful, and we sure enough want to come back. Most of all, thanks to each and every one of you wonderful, wonderful bluegrass loving people for being out there and being in the audience. And we definitely couldn't do this without the support of all you folks. And it's so fun, and it's an incredible journey to get to be out here and do something that I truly love to do. And all these gentlemen up here supporting each other. You know, we've got the title of this band under my name, but this band consists of one, and it's the five of us. We make one. Yeah. It's got nothing to do with my name or anything. I couldn't do this without the support of some of the greatest musicians I've ever had the privilege of working with. Yeah. Is all these guys right here. A big round of applause to Jared back there on the sound, because it has absolutely been wonderful. We love you, brother. Appreciate it. If I can never figure out some way or another to steal you away from Mickey and just take you on the road with me, I can do it. Well, we got an extra bunk. Don't whisper things that you don't mean, son. It's always incredible to work with such a fine group as the Davis Bradley Show. They are a dynamic duo, and they're tearing the world up right now. I'm proud of those two people very much. Proud to call them friends, and don't know what the future holds with these two bands together, but we definitely want to work more together and with each other. Special thanks once again to you, Richie, for all the work and helping me out. God bless you. Right now, we leave you with this bluegrass classic written by one of the greatest bluegrass bands ever, The Animals. Of course, The Animals looks like us in a golden corral. Well, there is a house in New Orleans they call the Rising Sun. It's been the ruins of many poor boys, and God, I know, I know I'm one.
sin and misery in the house of the rising sun.
Y'all to death. We appreciate that. That right there is what makes it worth it to us. You know, we don't have a lot of fun. We make a lot of money, but no, wait a minute. That's not right, is it? That wasn't right. That wasn't right. Was it?
I like it.
But no, like I say, just to look out there and see the different people, the reactions that they get from us, just being us, and that's what it's all about. We love you guys.
Yeah. Folks, y'all been wonderful tonight. We'll share one more gospel song with you. I tell you, time gets away from us.
That's all right.
Keep on playing. You could take another song or two, couldn't you?
Yeah.
I wish we could just load all each and every one of y'all up and just take you with us everywhere we go.
Tell
them
about
the church tomorrow. Yeah,
that's exactly right. Just down the road a little ways.
How far is that church from here, Mickey?
About 30 miles down in Georgetown.
Yeah,
right
before
you get
into
Georgetown.
Right before you get into Georgetown. Yeah, that right, Georgetown. Right, Georgetown. Right, right. Georgetown. Right, Georgetown. Right, Georgetown. Right, Georgetown.
Right, Georgetown. Right, Georgetown. Right, Georgetown. Right, Georgetown. Right, Georgetown. Right,
we'll share this gospel song with you, then we'll get out of here, folks. Thanks once again to Rivertown Bluegrass Society for letting the Kevin Prater Band be a part of their season. And we love everything that they do so much for the promotion of the music. share this gospel number with you and say God bless and good night. Meet us out in the lobby if you would, just shake and howdy. It'd mean the world to us. The title cut of our gospel album, right? Entitled, Were You There When They Crucified My Lord?
Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when they nailed him to the cross? Were you there when they nailed him to the cross? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble.
We love you. Thank you so much.
The Kevin Prater Band, how beautiful.
Boy, it's been a really good show here tonight, I think. Don't you? Come on, let's give the bands another great hand, please. I want to ask a question here. How many is in this building tonight and was here last year? Please stand up if you will. If you were in this building last year whenever these two bands were here. Wow, look at there. Now, for next year, would you like to see these two bands back again? Yeah. You gotta do better than that. All right, we'll see what we can work out with the bands. What do you think?
I'm gonna go ahead and clarify this. If we're here, we'll be here on the second Saturday of the month. You won't find that recorded anywhere else.
The second Saturday, not the first. And it's 5 o'clock, not 7.
5 o'clock.
I understand that it was put in a newspaper that it started at 7 o'clock. We had people that came in and bought tickets at 7 o'clock. This show, as always, this thing has been in business for 21 years and we have never started at 7 o'clock. I don't know where that come from.
If
all they had to do was look at our website and get the information off of it. It's very plain. I do want to recognize one other guy that's in here. David Taylor over here. Stand up, please.
Absolutely. French Creek, West Virginia.
French Creek, West Virginia. He drove 500 what? 512 miles.
Wow.
To see this right here. There's a little bit more to that. I met David last year up at French Creek Methodist Church. He's a member there. In fact, he's a deacon there. And my band went up and played there. And we played three or four shows up in West Virginia. Spent about a week up there, and his church was one of them. And I'm telling you, we really had a great time. And I've told everybody this. I enjoyed all the music that we played up there, but the church made the trip worth the while. Beautiful church, old church. He said it was built in the early 1800s, I think, and built with sound. You really don't even need a sound system in there, I'm telling you, and it's great sound. Just a great bunch of people. There's no way we could have been treated any better than we were there. And we appreciate that, David. We really do. And we're glad to have you here, too. As well as everybody, we appreciate everybody that's in this building tonight. Regardless of where you're from, and I know we got some from, how many here is from Canada? There is a few. How about North Carolina? Virginia. West Virginia. Well, where are the rest of them from? South Carolina.
South Carolina!
How about that?
New York.
New Jersey.
Yeah.
Pennsylvania.
Yeah.
Kentucky.
Yeah. Rhode Island.
Maine.
Maine.
My goodness. Ohio.
Yeah.
Boy, they're here from everywhere, let me tell you.
Wow.
And we appreciate you. We really do. And you know what? I said last year that if we'd had these bands back this year, in fact, we booked them last year while they were here, and we told you that they would be back this year. And I would say that everybody that was here last year is probably back this year. That could come. This, you know, was able to come, whatever. We have had a really good turnout tonight, but I would like to see this get bigger. If we get this place full, that means we might could take care of Kevin a little bit better. And Kathy. So we'd like to see all these seats full. You know, I remember when before everything got messed up with our governments, it was nothing to see 350 people in this auditorium. But seems like that's going away for some reason or other. And I would love to see it back. And you know what? If everybody in this building here would bring one person with them the next time, that could happen.
Next month is a grass town. Right?
Really?
And Alan Bobby come here. Big Greg Little.
I have not confirmed that, Greg, but it could be that Adam Bobby and the Grasstown will be here next month. Also, the Marsh Brothers will for sure be here. So keep a watch on the website, and there is one spot open for next month at this moment, but I will fill that in just as soon as. So keep a watch on the website, but it doesn't matter who's going to be here. There'll be a great band, I promise you that. It could be Grasstown. Could be right, right. Yeah, well. That's a good thing. Y'all like to see the Grasstown? All y'all coming back if I have Grasstown next month? Come on now, I gotta know. All right. You gonna bring somebody with you?
Yeah!
All right, I'm gonna depend on it now. Hey, by the way, we got 38 members, new members here tonight.
38 new members.
Yep. Hey. That's what it takes to make this thing go, I'm telling you. That's what we need. We need more of it. We need more help. And help, sitting in that seat, or coming in, buying a ticket, buying a membership, that's help. Believe it or not, that is help. And we appreciate it, everybody. So if you're not a member, I wanna encourage you to go out and join. Please go out and join. If you don't come, I told some of them tonight, if you don't, they say they don't come, but like three times a year. I said, that's fine. We'll put your money to good use. I'm going to turn these boys here, all and girl. loose here, and what do y'all want to pick?
We have no clue. We was hoping Tom Gray would know something by now. He's played more than the rest of us.
You know what? You know what? I'm telling you, you don't realize the talent that's on this stage right here tonight. Do y'all realize just what we have here tonight? Talent.
Oh, you're talking about eating?
Yeah.
Oh.
I'm talented here.
I bet. How long you been in the business, Kevin?
I'm celebrating 38 years.
In the professional business. In the professional, 38 years. How about you, Tom?
Okay. Four scores and 7 years.
Almost. Hey, I played my first gig with Bill Monroe when I was 18 years old, 1959.
Wow.
Great. Wow. I'm old.
Tell us all the ones you played with.
Tell them.
The different bands you played with.
Oh, gosh. It's a long...
The pro bands.
It's a long... Okay, the main ones I played with was Country Gentleman and The Seldom Seen. After that, well, Emmy Lou Harris and Davis Bradley. Right now, I'm playing with Eddie and Martha Adcock. I'm playing with the Valerie Smith Band.
There you go.
Yeah. So I'm still bumping along.
Richie, you want to tell them about you?
Oh, my God. Between the Navy and here, I've done nothing but music, man.
For how many years, Richie?
All of them.
Well, that didn't tell me anything.
Since about 1990.
Since about 1990. I'm the professional musician. He's also a luthier. Kevin was telling you about that earlier. All of these guys up here, these young guys over here on the fiddle, I mean, good gracious. I know it.
Right.
Can't you tell? Kathy, how long you been doing it?
Oh, goodness. All my life. I mean, I started.
That didn't tell me anything either.
I started very young with my family, played for probably 15, 18 years, took some time off when I had my kids, and now that they're grown and out, I'm back at it again. So, you know, a good 25, 30 years at least, you know.
In the professional line. I'm sorry?
Not that old.
And these other guys, these young guys back here, they can't be been in it that long, but boy, they're good musicians. How about that? But it's a pleasure to be standing on the stage here with this, to me.
I believe it is.
To me, I'm telling you, this is... Hey, Kevin.
How long you been in it? You've been doing it a while, too.
I'm 60 years old, and I've been playing music since I was six.
Well,
So you can you figure that out?
Take your shoes off.
Yeah. I know my ghost interest very well.
Do you, we need to get Jethro to figure it for you.
I can go send it for 60 no, real quick. No.
And you?
I started when I was 9, but like really playing in the 70s.
Started in the 70s professionally, right? Okay.
And I, like Kathy, I took a little bit of time off, but back at it.
Yeah. I guess Mr. Gray over here has got everybody top, but there's a lot of talent on this stage, I'm telling you. They played with a lot of bands. Kevin played with James King for years.
I just want to say one thing about Tom Gray. I grew up when I finally really got started into the world of bluegrass music. I actually come from Southern Gospel. I started playing electric guitar and acoustic guitar in a Southern Gospel band when I was 6 years old. When I heard a Seldom Seen for the very first time when I was 8 years old, my whole perspective toward bluegrass music changed, and it was him, John Starlin, John Duffy, and Mike Aldridge that truly taught me the gift of singing and what true instrumentation was really about, being behind the vocals and stuff. And far as bluegrass bass is concerned, this man right here deserves the title as one of the masters.
I agree. And I know y'all wanting us to shut up here. You're waiting to hear the music. I can tell because everybody's sitting there. You didn't have to agree with me.
The fiddler.
He reminds me the most of Curly Ray Klein on this stage as anybody I've ever seen.
Really? Oh, mercy me. There's a lot to say about me, but I don't know if I need to tell it in public or not.
Go ahead and tell it.
Oh, I started playing when I was 14. I'm 23 now. I ain't been playing for probably 9 years, maybe. Fiddle, and I started out playing the bass, and people like Tom, Jack Cook influenced me a lot, George Shuffler. And the only reason I played the fiddle is my great uncle's a fiddle player, and if it wasn't for listening to him, I'd probably never play a fiddle. But that's who got me started playing a bluegrass fiddle, was listening to him, and then listening to other fiddlers along the way.
Yeah. And to say something right quickly about this young man, tell you something that you don't know. He's been playing music for that length of time. I'm proud and very honored to say he's been playing fiddle full time almost a year, and this is the very first band that he ever played fiddle full time in, my man.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. It's good. No history?
I just want to tell your lie too. Everybody
else got no history.
I'm nervous.
Tell the truth.
What's the truth?
Well, don't tell the truth. They don't need to hear that.
Well, it's my lie. I'll tell it the way I want. I've been playing banjo for about 9 years now, and I reckon been playing professionally probably about 6. And like Adam with our great uncles, I had one that played banjo, and he was the only one that was still left out of the 4, and he kind of got us started and into it, and that's how I got an interest with the banjo, and heard people like Earl Scruggs and Sonny Osborne, and that really made me want to play more. And But it's just been part of what I do, and I really enjoy every bit of it. And my favorite part about getting out and playing professionally is getting to meet all the people around all different places. You gonna talk now?
No.
I am?
Yeah.
Do I get a hot dog now?
Yeah.
Really? Do I like hot dogs?
Really? I don't have a clue.
I love hot dogs. There's two others up there just right quick. I want them to share too. I want this gentleman right here behind me to share a little bit about his story. Well, Tom's got a pretty interesting life in the world of music too. Tom, tell him.
I'm only 16.
No, it's like you said, I started I'm 66 right now, and I started when I was about 12, around the local schools, churches, stuff like that, and got up into my late teens, early 20s, formed a sort of a local band around home, but had a lot of offers to go professional, but I got married and had a family, and I spent 39 years, 21 days, and 2 hours at the job that I retired from. But during the way, I was lucky enough to be the last Lonzo of Lonzo and Oscar, if you remember them from the Grand Ole Opry. I was with them for about 4 or 5 years, something like that. I learned so much from that gentleman, it wasn't funny. He was a gentleman, he was a scholar. He could cut you down in a heartbeat and never, and have you laughing the whole time at it. But I filled in with the likes of Bill Monroe. I sung on stage with the Osborne Brothers a couple of times, which was, you know, always everybody's dream. Just been in and out of it through the years, but mostly I love what I'm doing right now. I'm retired. These two guys, young guys that we got in our band, are blessings to us. They took about 20 years off of my life. But I've loved every minute of it. Wouldn't trade it for the world. Like I say, I've been in it about around 55 years, something like that. And like I say, I loved every minute of it. I haven't been able to do it as much as I wanted to, but what I did, I loved every minute. Like I told you a while ago, it takes people like you all to make people like us. I mean, we love it. We love it.
Just like everybody else up here on this stage, I've loved music all my life, almost 57 years old. They say I used to tear the playpen down when my dad and his brothers would start playing music, trying to get where that racket was coming from. And I still ain't got over it yet, but yeah, the night's real special for me. Finally get to meet Tom Gray's. Him and my dad is, no doubt in my mind, two of the best bass players ever. Stood beside one, and Tom, I sure appreciate you taking time talking to me, buddy. It just means a lot to me. I worked in the coal mines for 17 years and couldn't do this. I got totally disabled from that in 1995 and started fooling around with the band here and band there, but till I got with Kevin, I really didn't have anything solid to go out on the road and do or worth going. But yeah, I've been in a school band, fourth grade. I always played something like that. I played spoons before that because I couldn't sit still. And a lot of you understand what that means. If you got the bug, I had to do something other. But I'm just glad to be here and glad to be in this band and around all these good people tonight. Rich, yeah, I know a lot of people over Phelps, but we won't mention any names.
That's
right. I thought there was one of them.
We got one more on this stage here, this young, that I think is coming along really good here, and we're going to let the fiddlers over here share the stage a little bit. Garrett, you got, how long you been a picking, Garrett?
I started when I was 11, I'm 18 now.
So 7 years. Okay, and I can say that I'm proud to be in the band with Garrett. Garrett plays with the Subject to Change Bluegrass Band, and I'm proud to be a part of it with
it. Real good.
Yeah, it pays real good.
Pays real good.
Pays good, yes, sir. Kevin told me a while ago, he said back here in the background, he says, if I ever start sounding like Kathy here, you need to tell me. I said, well, I wish you had told me, because we could have pushed the button back there on the board to have done that. Then I asked him, had he rather sound like that or look like that? And he said either one, it was a money-making proposition for him.
We got to play a song.
Okay, we're going to turn them loose and...
what you want to do?
I guess we're going to do Will the Circle Being Broken or something like that.
Do a medley of it.
Do a medley.
Yeah.
That means we have to do like 3 or 4 songs together.
There you go. Right. Medley.
Yeah.
Medley.
Doesn't you say a medley of our biggest hits?
Medley of our
biggest
hits.
Yeah.
Singular.
Without ceasing.
I don't know what he's going to do. What's he going to do?
I guess we're going to start out with one and go to another.
We're going to start out with one and go to another. We'll leave it at that.
Two of you about your players or two of you about your bands.
I was standing by my window on a cold and cloudy day, when I saw that hearse come rolling for to carry my mother away.
Carry me home. up and sometimes down. I'm for to carry me home, a stew of my soul with heavenly bound. I'm for to carry me home. Coming for to carry me home, swing low, sweet chariot. Coming for to carry me home, Mr. Tom Gray. For to carry me home, swing low, sweet chariot. Coming for to carry me home, swing low, sweet chariot. Coming for to carry me home, Tom Gray. Be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by. There's a banner on the way here in the sky, Lord, in the... One more, help us out! Will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a banner on the way here in the sky, Lord,
our band's another hand. The Davis Bradley Band. Yeah. Kevin Prater Band. Yeah. What time we're still on, I want to say thank you to Michael, Davis in the back, recording our show tonight, streaming us live on YouTube, doing a fine job. We appreciate him so very much. And Jared Sellers on the sound did a wonderful job. Let's give these two guys a hand. Here at the Rivertown Bluegrass Society. Alrighty, we're gonna have door prizes and raffles and etc. right here real quick. Some Greg and Miss Patty's getting things together. So keep that in mind. Mickey did come up here.